So as we know that in distributed system, the common approach which is applied to provide the fault tolerance is just by replicating the data at the several sites or many sites. So in that particular case, if a site is not available, then it is required that the data should be available from the different sites whose copies are present at the different sites. So for that particular point of view, we have discussed the commit protocol, which can be very easily employed to update the multiple copies of the data which are available at the different sites. The second protocol which we have discussed, that is the non-blocking protocol, or you can call it as a three-phase protocol, which is able to tolerate the failure of the single site. But the ultimate requirement is that if there are more than one site which is going to failure, which is called multiple site failure, or if there is any communication failure, or there is a partitioning of the network, even though the data should be available wherever it is at the different sites, wherever they are available, it should be available on the request of the particular site. So to make multiple site failure, so that it should be resilient, even though if there are multiple site failure or the communication failure, but commit protocol is not going to overcome this problem, because what happens in commit protocol, whenever a site is not reachable, then the coordinator, what used to do, it used to send the message repeatedly, and ultimately when it is not able to contact the failure site, which is, you can call it as an unreachable site, then eventually the coordinator is going to decide and abort the transaction. So if the coordinator is going to decide the abort of the transaction, then it is going to deny the request of accessing the data. However, it is always advisable as well as desirable that the sites should continue to operate, even though when the other sites have failed, or at least one of the partitions should continue to operate after the system has been partitioned. So there must be certain way by which the accessing of the data must be available. So for that particular purpose, we are going to have apply another techniques, which is going to manage the replicated data in such a fashion that even though some of the sites have been crashed, even though the data which are available on the different site can be made available to the rest. So for that, we apply the voting algorithm, in which a voting mechanism is being used, and each replica is assigned with some certain number of votes, and a majority of votes has to be collected by a process before it is going to access the replica. So every site which is having the replica of the data have been assigned a certain number of votes, and the process which are in requirement of accessing the data have to acquire those votes, and it will be able to access the data if the read quorum is complete, because there must be a certain quorum, and that quorum can be made eligible if the process which is requesting is able to obtain certain number of votes. Now this voting mechanism is more fault tolerant in comparison to the commit protocol, because it allows the access of the data even though the site is failed, even though there is a network partition, even though there is a loss of the message, and all it is able to do without compromising the integrity of the data. So as far as the voting schemes are concerned, there are two schemes which are applied. One is static scheme, static voting, and second one is the dynamic voting. So let us discuss one by one today. In this I will be discussing about the static voting scheme, and first thing which is to be discussed is the system model. We know that the replicas of the data or the files are available at the different sites, and every file which has to be accessed, so for that accessing operation it requires that an appropriate lock is to be obtained. It is necessary to obtain the appropriate lock for accessing the file. Now as far as the rules are concerned for the locks which are granting, which is allowing somebody to read, that rule is file lock rule is either there is one writer and no reader, or there are multiple readers and no writers for accessing of the data simultaneously. And it is already assumed that every site there is a lock manager that performs the lock related operations, and every file is associated with a certain version number, which gives that the number of times the file have been updated. The version number states that how many times the file has been updated, and this version number is stored on the stable storage. And every successful write operation on the replica is going to update that version number. So the basic idea is that the which is associated with the voting algorithm is that it is going to control the access to the replicated data, and how it is being done, that every replica is assigned with a certain number of votes, and this is information again is stored on the stable storage. And whenever any process has to do certain read operation or it has to do write operation, they are permitted if they obtain certain number of votes, whether it is a read quorum is concerned or it is a write quorum is concerned, they have to collect respectively by the requesting process. So whenever any process is going to request, they will be sending the other sites which are having the replica of the information, they used to send the data along with their version number as well as the number of the votes which are assigned to that particular replica which is available on that site. Now the voting algorithm, how it works. So whenever there is a process which is being executed at a certain site I, and it is going to issue a read or the write request for a particular file, the voting algorithm is initiated. And how it is initiated, first of all, the site I, the process which is working on a site I, if it is in requirement of doing certain read request or the write request, first of all, it issues a lock request to its local lock manager. So the first step is to that the process which is working at a site, it is going to issue a lock request to its local lock manager. So when the lock request is granted by that local lock manager, then only the site I is going to send a vote request message to all the sites which are having the replica of that particular file, which the process wants to read or write. So when a site J, the other site, it is going to receive a vote request message, it issues a lock request to its local manager. Since it is working on the site J, so that site is going to give the lock request to its lock manager. And if that lock manager is going to grant that lock request from the site, then what it does, it returns the version number of the replica. And the version number of the replica is represented by version number J, because the version number J means the file which are stored, the replica which is stored at the site J, as well as it also sends the number of the votes which are assigned to that particular replica, that is VJ. VJ is the vote and VN is the version number. And both are associated with the J. So whatever J site is having the replica, which is having certain version number as well as the number of votes, then only it sends it to site I. Now, once the site I is going to receive these information, now the site I decides whether it has the quorum or not. And this is based on the replies which are being received within a particular time period. And if the request is for the read, if the request is for the read, then VR should be equal to summation of VK. Summation of VK means all the votes. Summation of VK, where K is in P. K is the element of P, where P is the set of the sites from which the replicas or the replies were received. So number of sites which are going to reply to the site I, whomsoever they are, whatever the votes which are associated with that particular replica associated at the different sites, they are being summed up. And that is known as VR. And if this VR is greater than or equal to R, where R is the read quorum, then only the site I will be able to succeed in obtaining the read quorum. Because the number of votes, VR is the summation of VK, where K is the element of P, where P is the set of the sites which replies the which replies has been received. So it will sum all the votes and it will calculate that sum of the votes as VR. And if this value of this VR is greater than or equal to R, where R is the read quorum, how this value of R is being defined, that will be coming later on. So if this value of VR is greater than R, then only the read, site I will be able to succeed in obtaining the read quorum. But if it is the write request, then write request, it will be trying to collect the votes. And that vote will be the summation of VK, where K in Q, K is in Q. Here K is in P. K is the element of P. Here K is an element of Q. What is the P? From this, P is the set from which the replies has been received, but Q is different. What is Q? Such that M is equal to maximum V and J, where J is in P. Jitne bhi sites ne reply kiya hai, that belongs to P. Usme se jiska version number higher hoga, that will be designated as M. So M is the maximum version number of that particular site J, where J is that site who has replied to the site I. And what is Q? Q is the J, value of J in P, where V and J is maximum. That value, that particular site J in that set P, where V and J is maximum. So only the votes. Now, the maximum value, how you will be finding? the significance of the maximum value m stands that the replica which was latest replicated, the latest current copy of the replica, because current copy of the replica will have maximum version number, and that particular site is considered as q. So it will those sites who have replied and those sites which is having maximum number of version, and out of that only those values are summed up who are having the maximum number of version number, unke votes ko hi count karke vw banaya jata hai. So only the votes of the current or the current replicas or the current version of the replicas are counted in deciding the write quorum. Read quorum ke liye itna importance nahi tha, but write quorum ke liye maximum version number ke jo sites hain jis pe replicas maximum version number ke hain unke votes ko count kiya jata hai. So that there is a difference in getting in achieving the read quorum as well as the write quorum. Now if this vw after obtaining the sum of vk with this process, if this vw is greater than or equal to w, where w is the write quorum, then the site I will be able to obtain the write quorum. So in this way, how to obtain the read quorum as well as the write quorum. Now the next point in this algorithm is if site I is not successful in getting the quorum, meaning thereby if this vr is not greater than or equal to r, whatever is required for the read quorum, if I is not successful in getting the quorum, it is going to issue a release lock to the lock manager as well as to all the sites that gave their votes. It is not able to access the data because the read quorum is not complete, because the value of vr is less than r, where r is the read quorum. So if it is not so, then the release lock it issues a release lock to the lock manager as well as all the sites to give their votes. But if I is able to successful in collecting the quorum, it has obtained the quorum, read quorum has been maintained, then what it will do, it will check whether its copy, whatever is available at locally, that file is current or not, whether the version number of that file is maximum or not, it is current or not. If the copy is current, its version number will be equal to m, and if it is not current, then what it will do, then the correct copy is obtained from that site that has the current copy. So once the current copy is available locally, the site I is going to perform the next step. And what is the next step? The next step is if the request is read, then the site I is going to read the current copy which is available now locally. And if the request is write, then site I is going to update the local copy. Once all the accesses to that particular copy are performed, the site I is going to update its version number, that is V and I. And then what it will do, it will send updates only to the current replicas. All the sites which belongs to Q, and the sites which belong to Q will be having the current replica. And since site I has updated its version number, so it updates current copy only. And then I sends the release lock request to its local manager, lock manager, as well as to the rest of the sites to whom it has already made contacts. So when all the sites after receiving the updates now going to perform the updates, and on receiving the release lock, they are going to release the locks. So this is all about the static algorithm, static voting algorithm. Now there is a reason why this algorithm is said to be a static voting algorithm. But before going to that, we will discuss first the how the vote is assigned. Suppose V is the total number of the votes which are assigned to all copies. And the value of R, which is the read quorum, and the value of W, which is the write quorum, are selected. How to select it? We can select it. So the value of R and value of W, which are selected such that R plus W should be greater than V, where V is the total number of the votes assigned to all copies. So read R and W are selected in such a way that R plus W should be greater than V, as well as W should be greater than V by 2, whatever is the total number of the votes. If you want to have a write quorum, if a process wants to update by writing operation, it has number of votes more than 50% votes. That is why W is greater than V by 2. So with this, what we want to infer, the values of R as well as W, combined with the fact that write operation updates only the current copy, and it is going to give the guarantee that the first guarantee what it used to give, that none of the obsolete copies are updated due to the write operation. Now, it is the property of the static voting algorithm that only those replicas which are having current copy is being updated by an updation operation by a certain process at a particular site. Not all the copies are updated, only the current copies are updated. And that is what the first point is, that obsolete copies are not updated. No obsolete copies are updated by static voting algorithm. So there is a subset of the replica that are current and whose votes total to the W. Only that is being. The third one is there is no null intersection between every read quorum and the write quorum. That is, that in any read quorum which is gathered, irrespective of the site that is going to participate in that particular quorum, there will be at least one current copy which is selected for reading. The sole purpose is that. And as far as the write quorum is concerned, the write quorum W should be high enough to disallow simultaneous writes on the two distinct subsets of the replica. So that is all the property of the static voting algorithm. Now this algorithm can be modified just to make the system performance better and better, because in this particular algorithm, static voting algorithm, it is not necessary to count the votes from the current replica only to obtain the right quorum. Besides that, obsolete replicas can be updated whenever a write operation is performed. And by doing this, the performance of the system will be increased. So that is the modification has been suggested in the static voting algorithm. Now, as far as the main points or the important point related to the voting scheme is that the performance and the reliability characteristic of the system can be altered, can be changed by assigning the number of the votes to each replica and carefully selecting the values of R as well as the W. Now, let us consider that we have four replicas at the four different sites. And the votes which are assigned V1 is assigned with 1, V2 is assigned with 1, V3 is assigned with 2, and V4 is assigned with 1. With certain disk latency. Now, if we have selected a value R is equal to 1 and W is equal to 5, because total number of the votes are 1 plus 1, 2, 2, 2, 4, and it's 5. So if we have selected the R value is equal to 1 and W is equal to 5, is it possible to have a right quorum complete? No, it's not possible. Now, suppose that if we change the configuration and quorum is also changed, and I have changed the configuration in the quorum that R is equal to 3 and W is equal to 3. Then again, the system is unavailable for the writes only when two sites, site 3 and any one of the three sites, are inaccessible simultaneously. Hence, by carefully selecting the value of the quorum, the configuration can be made more reliable of the system as far as the configurations are concerned. One more thing which we have to take care that we should look for that particular site which is more reliable. And those sites which are more reliable should be assigned good number of votes instead of assigning a good number of votes to unreliable site. So that whenever we are in requirement of doing the voting, so that whenever we are in requirement of obtaining the quorum as far as the read or the write is concerned, it can be done very easily. So that is why, in a particular system, since these values are fixed, number of votes are fixed, so we cannot alter. Once we define the value of the votes, it is fixed. That is why it is called a static voting algorithm. And that is why we are in need of some kind of dynamism in allotting the votes, number of votes, to the different sites where the replica is residing. So that is why we look for the dynamic voting, which is going to adopt the number of the votes or the set of the sites that can form a quorum by changing the state of the site due to site failure or due to the communication failure. So that is why we always look for such kind of system in which we can do the dynamic voting process. Depending upon the situation, we can change the number of the votes which are available at the different sites. And for applying the dynamic voting, we have two approaches. One is majority-based approach, and another is the dynamic vote reassignment. So what is the different approaches? We will discuss it later on.